Hi, I'm Angeline Corvalha, and I'm going to walk you through how to best use the educational materials that are available free of charge on my Data Girl and Friends website. So when you go to our website, datagirlandfriends.com, you end up on the homepage where you can have information about who we are, how we work, what our principles are, AI awareness, online safety, privacy, and digital citizenship, and then our mission, the things that we focus on, a lot of different materials. What we're here for today is the educational materials for parents and teachers to do with their kids. So there's two ways to get there. One of them is, as you just saw, you go to the How We Learn rules of the game, and you can click on the Discovery Squad or the Digital Navigators. I'll just get into the difference between those in a minute. I'm going to scroll down. Well, you have the links again here on the homepage to those same pages. The Discovery Squad are younger kids around 8 to 10 years who don't have very much experience online. So what the educational materials are trying to do is give them a solid, safe basis for how to use the digital world in a responsible way that will keep them safe. And the other one, the Digital Navigators, are for older children around the early teens, usually, who already are online. They know a lot about the online world, but they often, I would say almost always, have important gaps that they don't know that is maybe causing them to do things that isn't always safe or the best way for doing things. So what we're trying to do is fill those gaps. What I'm going to do is show you the Discovery Squad page because both are set up in a similar way. We have obviously a short description of the Discovery Squad, what I just gave you, and then you scroll down and you find educational workbooks. Under there, we have our educational videos that are organized by kind of the topic. So if you click on them, it opens in a separate page and you can watch the video. Underneath that, we do have some kind of additional exercises like thinking about our independence and a game where you can move the objects if it's a good idea or not. So just depending on the age, we have a crossword and all of this. So you can try that out, but I want to show you the educational workbooks. You can see some of them have This is Data Girl, and some of them have Isla AI Girl. So if you have Isla AI Girl, these educational workbooks are going to be about AI in some way. And if there's Data Girl or some other image, it's going to be about online safety and privacy and those other topics. So when you click on the image, it opens in a separate page, and then you get to this interactive workbook. You have on the first page, each one is the same structure. There's a video, there's a story, and there's some other kind of learning activities. And on the last page, there's some recommendations for parents about what kind of discussions to have with their kids to help them really deepen the learning. So you can either click here to get to the page you're interested in, or you just flip the page and you're here on this page. Cost of free apps is this video. You can either click here or click here. So I click on the image and this pop-up opens and you can watch the video, the cost of free apps. Here you have the most important things that this video teaches. And in each of the videos, in each of these pages, you also have an image here. It's either an image or a PDF that opens on a separate page with more information that kind of helps deepen the messages from the videos. In this case, this ways that a digital defender protects their data online, just to kind of review what was said in the video. Then there's a short message for the kids. And then going to the next page, we have a story. So this is just an audio story. So you click on it and it opens on a separate page, and then you can listen to the story. And here you have an activity. Each one is different. In this case, there's a coloring page that goes along with the story, just to, again, make it a little bit more entertaining for the kids to be learning, but in a fun way. And then finally, on the last page, we have some help for parents explaining what I just said about how we watch and we listen, we do some activities to learn, and also giving tips about questions to ask with your child and talk with your child, because my method is really about learning together, because we have a digital generation that learns very quickly about the online world, and they feel much more confident than they often should. And what we as adults can bring to them is that we have experience in the world. We know things that risks that come up. So we combine our experience and we can really understand how to be safe and responsible online. It's also about peer-to-peer sharing. So if you have different children that would watch it together and talk about it together, they can also tell each other about their experiences and really have a much, much deeper learning experience and more fun learning experience than just sitting and doing everything by yourself. So the last thing I want to show is just on the last page, we have links to follow us on LinkedIn, Instagram, Vimeo, YouTube, and there's a link to the webpage and a link to Spotify. But the stories are on all major podcast providers. And most of the time we post on LinkedIn. There's not very much on the other social media. So thank you so much for listening. I really hope that you enjoy our educational materials and you really get something from them. Please let me know if you like it, don't like it. Give me the feedback. How does it go with your kids? What are they interested in? What could we add? Anything you'd like to let me know, please do. Thank you.